The ACMA's EME Checker lets you see the levels of EME measured at a selection of 5G-enabled mobile base station sites around Australia. The ACMA doesn't set the standards for safe EME levels. That's the job of ARPANSA, the Australian Radiation Protection and Nuclear Safety Agency. But we do measure and monitor compliance with the standards. EME Checker uses data sourced from our 5G and EME measurement program. There's more information about how we measure EME on our website. Let me take you through how EME Checker works. Start by clicking Search for a location, which brings us to the landing page. On the landing page, this map shows all the sites around the country that we've measured. Our measurement program is ongoing, and so more sites are continually being added to EME Checker. And because mobile networks grow and change, we're also re-measuring sites that we've previously visited, making historical analysis of EME possible over time. EME Checker provides 5 different measurement reports, which can be accessed here at these blue tabs. At the top left of the landing page, there is a search tool that allows us to search for a location. Let's look at some examples. Say you want to look at a postcode in Victoria, 3030. You can see we've measured sites in 3 suburbs for postcode 3030. Derrimut, Point Cook and Werribee. Let's select Werribee from the list. The map on the landing page now shows that we've measured 2 sites in Werribee. So let's now look at each of the tabs, starting with the average and maximum EME per site report. This report shows the average and the maximum level of EME as a percentage of the ARPANSA safety limit and compares those levels with the maximum EME that the mobile carriers predicted. Here we've measured the total EME between 420 MHz and 6 GHz, which includes all the primary mobile phone service bands that are used to deliver 3G, 4G and 5G. We intentionally use a linear measurement scale to show the level of EME as a percentage of the safety limit. The small bars illustrate the very low levels of EME. The map shows we've measured 2 sites in Werribee, and the graphs show that the site selected has been measured twice. Once in March 2021, where the average EME was 1.42% of the safety limit, and again in May 2021, where the average EME was 1.32% of the safety limit. You can see the corresponding measured maximum and carrier predicted levels for each measurement date as well. It's interesting to note the conservative nature of the predicted EME level when compared with what was actually measured. In most cases, actual measured levels are less than 50% of the predicted levels. Let's move to the third tab, EME for all frequencies per site report. This shows a spectrum plot of the average EME for all frequencies between 420 MHz and 6 GHz measured over 30 minutes. Here we can see what was being transmitted from the base station. In this case, we have 3 low band and 6 mid band services on air, each represented by the spike at the corresponding frequency. This view makes it very easy to compare the EME levels measured from each of the mobile phone bands, as well as other technologies if they were present, such as Wi-Fi, television and two-way radio. It's very common to see that the 5G signals appearing on the higher frequencies have the lowest EME levels of all the mobile phone technologies, typically due to the efficiencies of 5G, such as beamforming. Let's now choose the 5G beamforming EME per site tab. This report looks at the EME we measured within a beamformed transmission from a 5G-enabled base station. These measurements are then recorded as a percentage of the ARPANSA safety limit. As each network operator uses a different segment of the band to deliver 5G, we've shown beamforming measurements for one selected network operator at a time. Again, we used a linear scale to illustrate how small the beamformed EME levels actually are. This shows that our site in Werribee has a TPG 5G service and that we measured the maximum beamformed EME in March 2021 at 1.89% of the safety limit. Let me show you another example. Let's look at Abbotsbury. These are the maximum levels of 5G beamformed EME at an Optus site in Abbotsbury in New South Wales, where we measured twice, once in February 2022 and again in March 2022. I'll now move to the fifth tab, All Sites Average and Maximum EME. This report shows the average, maximum and predicted EME for all sites that have been measured. We've used different coloured bars to show average, maximum and predicted levels at each site. You can sort by site name, average EME, maximum EME or predicted EME. Scrolling down the page displays all measured sites in the order selected. An interesting observation with this report, sorting on average EME, you'll notice that the majority of sites measured have EME at less than 1% of the safety limit. We'll now move to the last tab in EME Checker, All Sites 5G Beamforming. Similar to the previous report, this looks at the maximum beamformed EME for all the sites that have been measured. You can sort by site name or by maximum beamforming EME. You'll note here in the legend that the technology measured has a name, for example, Optus NR3500. This means that the measurement refers to an Optus 5G service on 3500 MHz. Different colours identify the mobile network operator measured at each site, and if you hover, you'll get information about each measurement. Thanks for learning about our EME Checker. Keep coming back, as we will be adding more measurements at more sites around the country.